How do people do some of these videos with a picture in a picture and multiple windows and including photos and videos and titles? It's very, very easy, and we're going to show you how it's done. Hey everybody, what we're going to have a look at today is another very cool feature built into vMix, and that's virtual inputs. Now, a virtual input is a carbon copy of an input that you've already brought into vMix. So what we're going to do, we're going to double click on this camera input, go up to General, and in this top menu area, just click Create Virtual Input. And now you have a carbon copy of that camera input that you brought into vMix. Now, why might you want a virtual input? You can do inserts of pictures and videos and titles and so many other things. But the thing about virtual input is that they have no audio associated with them. So you will always want to bring your audio in separately. Now what we're going to do, we're going to add a title to that virtual input. So we go to Add Input, Title, this title here, and then we're going to put a little information in this title. Now we've got our title in there, and we're going to double click on the virtual input, and we're going to do a multi-view. And number one is full screen, so we're going to find that title, add that title to the virtual input. And the way you can use that is that you can change back and forth between the virtual input and the camera with the title, so you don't show it all the time. Sometimes it gets a little invasive, a little in a way. You can also click on number one, which is a full screen, and bring that up to show the title. Or you could just click on the original camera on number one on the title and show that. So there's a couple different ways to do that. But virtual inputs, again, you can add inserts of pictures and video and some other information. Real quick on these instant buttons, the 1, 2, 3, and 4 down below your inputs. You can change how any one of those present what it does when you click on. Number one is a full screen input. And number two is also full screen input. Number three and four are multi-view inputs, and you can change the size of those, or you can reposition them anywhere you want to. But again, any of those buttons down there, 1, 2, 3, and 4, you go into overlay and you can change how those present when you click on them. Now this may look a little more complicated than it really is. It's not that hard, and once you get a copy of vMix and play around with it a little bit, and they've got a whole list of help files online that can show you step by step by step how to do these things. It really is pretty easy. It won't take you long to learn all these tricks and how to do these different things. Now something else, and it can get a little confusing, because when you add another virtual input, is this says virtual input, and we're going to add one here. Go up to General again, top menu, lower right, create virtual input. Now, both of those are called virtual inputs, and it can get a little confusing. So all you need to do is click on this cogwheel and change the name of that virtual input. So we're going to call this virtual input 1. And we'll call this virtual input 2. And now they just become a little easier to manage, track what virtual input is what virtual input. So virtual input 1 has a title, and now what we're going to do is add an image. So we'll come down here, add this image here, and we're going to make that widescreen so it looks just a little bit better. And now on virtual input 2, we're going to add that picture to virtual input 2. Now, virtual inputs are usually associated with multi-view. And multi-view has a wide range of different types of inputs you can use. Of course, virtual input one is full screen. That's when we use title. You can use side-by-side, top-bottom, split overview, up, top-bottom. But we're going to use number two here. So we're going to find this photo and add that photo as a different view when you want to present a photo during your recording or live stream. So all you have to do again, you can cut that back and forth like that. Use button number one, which is full screen, and bring it up. And several different ways you could do that. But also on multi-view, if you think that photo isn't in the right position, you can do the same thing you could do when you change those. You can move that picture around. So we're just going to open that up, and you can drag that picture wherever you want it. And you can also change the size of it in multi-view. So we're position, overlay number two, and we can make it larger or make it smaller. And again, we can move that picture wherever we'd like to have that to change the way it is presented. And it is some really very cool stuff, and this is a part of vMix. Now again, virtual inputs can be used for a wide range of things, for titles, for pictures, for videos, and really make your recording or your live stream really something special. Now I've already brought in another virtual input and a video. And what I've done, I've added that video as a multi-view. I've added it as number two. And again, you can move that video around wherever you want it. You can resize that video, make it smaller, make it bigger, or whatever looks best for you. And then during your recording or your live stream, you can present that video as part of your show. You can, again, move it back and forth. This is the output window. This is the standby window. Or you can just go down and click on number one and bring that in to your show. And really make some really neat recordings and live stream shows with virtual inputs. Now again, virtual inputs are limited by the number of inputs that your vMix package will allow. But on a laptop, you can see fewer of these inputs on the bottom. And so what you can do is bring those inputs in under these different color buttons to help manage them easier. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create another virtual input. And the menu, create virtual input. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on that, name that virtual input 5, I guess. And then I'm going to click this red button. And now that virtual input is on that red button, you can click back and forth to manage these different inputs you have in vMix. But something I did a while back during a live show we were doing, I'm going to open this. I'm going to go to color adjust. I'm going to take the color all the way out of it and make it a black and white input. But the reason I did that, I'm going to add something else. I'm going to add a title, and I'm going to add a text title. And let's see, this add, let me open this. I'm going to take this text. and change that. And then I'm going to double click on that virtual input, multi-view, full screen, text title. And that's the way I used another virtual input, was when I was talking about what I had received from this gentleman about something I talked about a while back. But anyway, it works out real well and makes that just absolutely super. And just, again, the virtual inputs, you can use them with titles, pictures, videos, and so many more things. Really make your recording or your live stream event really shine. You may be saying to yourself, wow, that really looks hard. It isn't that hard. And just a little time with vMix and using virtual inputs, associated multi-view, you'll be adding these to your recordings and live stream events in no time. Now, if you're not familiar with what vMix is, it is a live production, recording, camera mixing software for your Windows computer. They have a 60-day free trial. They have several different versions, from basic, which is free, all the way up to 4K. vMix has also added live production hardware, and you can check us out on their site. And when you get vMix, it also includes titles that you can use with your video recording or live stream event, and also includes virtual sets. And vMix has added a third party who is creating some really nice virtual sets for your video or live streaming event. And with vMix, you could add live social media to your recording or live stream event. If you got any comments or questions, leave them down below. I'll do the best I can to answer for you. If you'd like to check out a really nice webcam, it's the one I'm using now. It's a C930E, and I use it around here all the time. I did a demo on it, and you can check that video out. Or if you use vMix or have a YouTube channel you'd like to talk about, let's set up a Skype interview, and then we'll tell everyone about you. So for me here in Pendleton, Indiana, to you wherever you are, hoping that you have the best day ever. For the Pendleton Gazette, this is George Price.